and give us the energy to make it the whole way. And also, I'll be reacting to Olivia Rodrigo's new album today. All her songs are very good except for the latest single, honestly. But it's a different style, you know, it's a different taste. I don't understand. I feel like so out of breath.
You haven't even started running.
I know.
How are you gonna make it? You know, it's like 4 miles, right?
Yeah, 4 miles, 8 miles. I can't even jog for 1 mile straight.
It's a bad idea, right?
It's the morning, like 1 p.m. We're gonna go on a jog today. We're gonna jog to Washington Square from the house, which I will show you all that distance. We're gonna go there, jog, keep a pace, and then not get rewarded yet. We're not gonna get bubble tea or pastry or anything like that until we go jog back, and then we're gonna drive back there to charge the car. Ba-ba. Ooh. So first, I've never taken pre-workout my whole life, and I've also never jogged for this long my whole life, so we drink it on camera.
What, really? You do it dry? It's like smoking cocaine.
All right, we're doing jugs today.
How are these?
Is it caffeine in it? It sure is good for the liver.
Like, it makes you superhuman.
Oh, really? It's like drugs. You just drink it like dry? Really? That's what you will do?
Put your mouth, swallow, salivate.
Okay.
Here, have some water.
Yeah, I feel awake, so I won't really run long distance. You should keep your heartbeat down.
Hey! Hey! Hey!
Just started feeling the music. Nothing yet. You guys updated. Mile one in the books. I'm feeling like there's a mile 10 for me. You know, mile one is probably mile 10 for me. I haven't ran like jogging style in probably about what, 5-6 years? This is mile two right here. I've started walking, but it's okay. I'm trying to push through. It's like I feel lactic acid in my legs. It's not much that I'm out of breath. It's just, I haven't ran like this in a while. So my legs aren't used to it.
Okay, I think I've hit my limit. I think we're on our way to 3 miles. I don't think I can make it. I think we have to start making back. We did make it to a plaza mall, but not the one that we intended to make it to.
This is probably around mile four. Haven't ran, just been walking. Burning the calories. We're preventing diabetes, preventing kidney stones. This life is crazy, but it led me to your love. If you follow me forever, I will come. The endorphins. All showered up. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to where we were heading on that jog to charge the car, but also to finally reward ourselves. Everything hurts. I don't wanna be what you want me to be. But yes, we are going to react to that Olivia Rodrigo album tonight. What do they call the Olivia fans?
16% right now.
Wow, that's kind of smart. That's like a smart car.
Is it plugged in?
I'm so tired.
Body's aching, but we're here. We're here for the reward.
I'm about to carb load for my sleeping session in a little bit.
Here you are now.
Let's eat.
Here we are.
Here we are.
I don't know why I waited till 12, but it is 12 o'clock on September 8th, and the new Olivia Rodrigo album has dropped, and I'm pretty sure it dropped at 9 o'clock, but I just waited till 12. Just, you know, just for the authenticity. So excited for today. I have her YouTube channel, Guts. So there's 12 songs on the album. Teenage Dream. It's the last one on the album. It's kind of bold. Whew, all right, I'm pretty excited. Let's do this. Let's listen to it in order. Let's do All American Bitch. Okay, first off, this is not what I expected this song to sound like. I thought it'd be more like, you know, brutal or bad idea, right? Slow acoustic ballad. I feel it. Lyrical genius.
Oh shit.
All Never mind. That was the type of song I expected from that title. She's so versatile. Bad Idea, right? We already listened to. Vampire. I already listened to. I'm loving it already. I'm really liking the vibe of this album as well, or at least All American Bitch. Lacey is a very laid back song, very slow song, and that's my type of song. How great of a lyricist she is. She's really showcasing that so far. Ballad of a Homeschooled Girl. I see she's leaning into that rock and roll old school music. Rebel. Here she goes again with the talking rap. Not your typical pop star. Her lyrics make you feel some sort of way, don't it? Making the hashtag relatable. Woo! Red lights. I love this lead up. I think this is probably the fourth song that we listened to, but this one is by far my favorite. I'm really glad, I mean, just from the first four songs, I'm really glad that she's stepping away from writing songs about, you know, like a boy. So far, it shows how much she's matured as an artist. This song is about sort of self-reflecting, and it's like an internal struggle that she's singing about, and I love that. Another slow song. Yeah. This song's about a boy right here. Tell him. I fell for you like water. Falls from the February start. Ooh. So, the song was so simple. It barely had any background music, and all it was her voice. Her voice and her songwriting made it a good song. She needed nothing else. Incredible. Maybe I'm just biased. Get him back. She's in her new era. Love is embarrassing.
Hey bro, I still love you, bro. So
Ooh.
Stupid.
The Grudge. My gosh. Is this on purpose? Every single commercial has been on milk. Are they saying that I need milk? Like, what? If nightmares each week, but that Friday and May, one phone call from you and my entire world was changed. And still lingers, took everything I loved and crushed it in between your fingers. Ooh. Not now you ever think about the damage that you did, but I hold on to every detail in love. Now I hold it like a grudge. Now I hear your voice every time that I think I'm not enough. And I try to be tough, but I want to scream. How could anybody do it? Similar to Vampire. Pretty isn't pretty. I have a feeling this is gonna be a banger right here. Banger! Already! Oh, very. Pretty upbeat, but the lyrics are pretty sad. Her 12th song, the last one, Teenage Dream. I don't really relate to this, but it hits hard. So after the first listen, I don't know what to make of it yet. I don't know what my favorite songs are yet, but I am definitely really feeling Making the Bed. Just as like high level first time listening, and I really appreciated that she didn't just go for the generic poppy vibe pop songs that would probably get to the top 10 of Billboard. She really wanted to let the listeners know that it was her behind those lyrics. Like, this was not manufactured by a label, this was her. And I think that's why she's such an amazing artist, because everything is so unique. Now she's basically paving her own way in the industry. Not doing what the other artists are doing, but just writing genius lyrics, slow song that a lot of people can relate to. Like, she definitely did step out of her comfort zone in like Bad Idea, Right? And some of the other songs, that is different than what she normally does. And she does such a great job at expanding her sound. But it's fun, it's different. Even though that's not my thing, I appreciate that she went for it. You know, I definitely need more time to just listen to them and really appreciate each song individually. She definitely did not disappoint. We always knew she would deliver. But it's been like 2 years since her last album. Definitely worth a wait. Now that it's out, like, I don't know what to do. I'll be playing the album on repeat in the pharmacy for the next couple of weeks. Peace out.